Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to check about a smart narrative visual in the Visuals with Nags series. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So what is this visual is all about? It's like it is an AI powered visual and it used to quickly summarize visuals and reports in a text format. Okay. And to address key takeaways. See, because this is very important, because once you create a report and understanding insight out of it, what this report is saying to me, it is very difficult to understand for most of the people, especially those who are in technical background. And this particular smart narrative visual will give you a data story about your entire report or the visual. That is the a quick thing you can do it using this visual. And use smart narratives in PowerPoint. Basically, like in PowerPoint, people has to type what are the key takeaways, and we can use this when you use the smart narratives, you can take a screenshot or you can embed it so that the data get reflected once the new data comes in. So no need to type in the PowerPoint. Your workload from your manual intervention to write those data stories will be reduced. So as I said in the previous point, it helps you to tell a data story, right? So this is what this visual is all about. And there are certain limitations to this visual. You cannot publish to web, Power BI report server, it is not supported. Analysis services, either Tableau, multidimensional or Azure, no analysis services is allowed. And map visual with non-aggregated latitude and latitude, multi-row card. So if you use multi-row card and it uses more than three categorical, then this will not work out. And cards with non-numerical measure, sometimes we will say like first of last of the textual issues, those things will not be considered. If you use the calculation groups, this smart narratives won't work. Let's try to understand it, what this smart narrative, and we'll go to Power BI now. So now we are saying like this is Naga Garments data. We know like it contains the total sales amount, how many quantities sold in the different locations and years, and whether it's on shop or online order by categories. Now, while seeing it, I cannot able to analyze much. I need to intervene manually, like whether this year is less than this year, or in this category, this is highest. Everything I need to narrate, right? I need to understand myself. Instead, if Power BI itself tells me what is doing well, what is not, then that will be better, right? That is what this smart narrative do. In order to do for the entire report, I have created some space. You can press this smart narrative visual. Once you click on it, it will automatically create a summary for you. You can see here, you can increase the entire font size to 16 so that it will be easy to understand. Let's walk through what it generated for us. Now you can see 263,5700, that is casual wear, had the highest item amount and was 806% higher than the accessories. So it is trying to compare the least categorical value with the highest value. So that is what it happened here. So that is the point about here. And the lowest value for the accessories is this one, 2900. And casual wear had the highest item amount. Okay, this is having highest item amount, followed by semi-formal, formal and accessories. So this is how usually people will be narrating the stories. So this smart narrative will give you that analytical capability for you. And also you can see all other points over here. And I just want to highlight some other points. Now you want to make something dynamic, like this is everything is dynamic. What I'm trying to say is when you click on only on shop, all these things will change based on your selection. Okay, based on your selection, the smart narrative keep on changing the some values based on the selection you have made. If you choose 2019, then what was the different narrative stories based on that selection. Okay, so this is again interactive. It will interact with the other visuals. And one important point I want to make here is, like, you can dynamically set some value, or you can try to edit some content here, like the total sales in Chennai, okay, something like that. Okay, anything you can add. And what I'm saying is, like, you can able to add your text on your own. Okay, this is the summary of this particular analysis, like that content, or you want to add some headers or footers, whatever you can add. On top of that, you can add your own calculations. That is what I'm saying. So let me add some value here. Chennai, okay, total sales in Chennai, that's what I want. Now here I can start typing total item amount in Chennai. Okay, this is the one of the location. So total item amount in Chennai. Okay, this is the value. You can see what is the value here. When you click on it, that will appear. So I can make that value over here. You can see here the total value in Chennai is, okay, that is the value. You can start writing it. So you can write your own calculations by using a question and answer feature, and the value will be replicated here. You can format this text along with the other text or to align with it. So now you can see the total sales in Chennai is. So when you click on it, so that value will appear, 108, that is what it's appearing here. When you click on some other period in 2020 and Chennai, 336, that will reflect here. And if you uncheck it, it will still show the Chennai value, okay? And apart from the selection, here we have unselected, but we have filtered only for Chennai in question and answer, right? So question and answer feature embedded here, and this value is totally formattable. Like how you can format is, like, you can click on this visual and you can start editing the values, like currency, whether it's in US dollars. So say for example it's in US dollars, so I can put that value over here, and this value also totally formattable. Okay, now it's appearing. So this is how you can format it. So basically you can have for the entire report. Now another important feature I want to highlight is, like, we will remove this smart narrative here, and I can enable the smart narrative only for this visual. How you can do it? Click on it and then use summarize. So when you click on it, it will summarize for only for this visual. Okay, so you can see at 244030 is a cash flow, we had the highest amount. So it will give you the smart narrative story. So if you want to add some other contents, you can add it. As I mentioned below, that will be dynamically changing based on your selection. I hope you understand this property. I hope you understand this visual. And you can see here, as soon as you click on it, the visualization pane will disappear. You will have only the format box for it when you touch it. So other properties remain same, like there are nothing more you can add. These are the generic properties. Only thing you need to worry about this plus value, that is, you can add a dynamic value here. I hope you like this video. If you like it, press the thumbs up button and comment below for your queries. And do remember that data is your asset.